Dave, we spoke about future of work previously, like what the future of work of yours is going to look like. But then the pandemic hit, and I think things have a little bit changed, and some there are new jobs now being created, and some old job has been removed. So what do you think the future of work is going to look like?
My first reaction is, I hear a lot of people telling me, here's the new normal.
Yeah.
And my first reaction is run away from those people. Because anybody who says they have the new normal probably doesn't. I mean, a year ago in January, my wife and I planned out 2020. Nothing happened.
Canceled everything.
Everything canceled. I travel a lot. I average 200 airplane flights a year. Last year, I did zero.
Mm-hmm.
So for me to say, here's the future, I don't know. So having said that, let me tell you a couple of principles. Not exactly. I think we're going to have to learn to harness uncertainty. What that means is the world is uncertain. Instead of being threatened by it, instead of trying to control it, we harness it. I love the metaphor of a harness. I don't know if you've ever had a dog as a pet. You put a harness on the dog, you give them freedom with the breed. And the harness gives a dog a space. By the way, employees are not dogs. We're not dogs. I'm not a dog. But harnessing uncertainty means learning to navigate it, learning to spend time with it, learning to tame my apprehensions. So I think the future work is going to be harnessing uncertainty. It's going to be adapting quickly. It's going to be doing things today that will be successful. And having said all that, I'm going to now show all my friends that I don't speak good French. So I'm going to say a French word, then I'll translate it. Plus ça change, plus c'est la même chose. The more things change, the more they're the same. Some people say work is going to be brand new. No, the basic principle of work is we create a product or service that a customer values.
Yes.
That's going to continue. Now, those values change. Kentucky Fried Chicken had to change its name to KFC because people didn't want fried chicken. They wanted KFC. By the way, it's the same chicken.
Yeah.
But I think we see the values of people changing. I think we see a little more sensitivity in the world around empathy and feeling and personalization.
Yeah.
So work's going to change in ways that help create value for our changing customers. So my advice to those of us in HR, stay connected to your customer. Stay connected to your customer. What are they experiencing that I can help them have a better experience? That's my advice.
Yeah. That's a very, very important, staying connected, because we are humans. We like to be connected. We are social people, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely. In fact, I think one of the things we're seeing, we're isolated socially because I'm in my home office, you're in your office, and we're living isolated, but we can't be isolated personally.
Yeah.
And so I've had the privilege, Mher, of working with you now for about 3 years. Every time I see you, even after a long time, you smile, your beard, you look so good. And it makes me feel better. I invite people when they see me on video into my office. They get to see the, the things in my office that make me who I am. I've had the privilege of peeking into 100 offices this year at home and getting to know people. And I think sometimes that technology that separates us physically does not separate us socially.
Yeah. I totally agree with you. We are people's. I believe one time when I was a Zoom call, and I think it was in UK with the minister, and the child came. It was very like, oh, what happened? And now the cats come, the dogs come, and it's normal.
And it's okay.
Yeah.
Guess what? It's okay. I've learned about people's father in my office. If you see it, I have a picture of Dr. Martin Luther King.
Yeah.
When I was a young man, he was very influential in my life. About thinking about racial justice and equity. I have a picture of my father who served food to the homeless the last 20 years of his life. You get to know a little bit about who I am because these are symbols. And I love that. We get to see the minister's children, their cats, their dogs. Anyway, I think that sense of belonging is good, but we still need to be in person at times. There is still something to be said of touching and feeling
And hugging.
And hugging,
Thank you
without a mask, without a mask, may I add.
Thank you for that, Dave. And again, for the audience watching and listening, if you like this video, please like and share. And tune in next time for another great question with Dave.